call this meeting to order. Please rise for the pledge of allegiance. Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Good morning, everyone. Welcome. Welcome to Big Creek Park and Minor Center. I want to start off by introducing our newest board member, Mr. Pat Preston, Patrick Newberry. It's great to have you on the board. I know Pat is a very generous member of our community. He definitely serves the Geauga County community at large. Speaking for myself as a Middlefield resident, Cardinal Husky, I know he's been very generous to Cardinal schools and like I just said, the Geauga County community at large. So I don't know if you want to say a few words, Pat, but welcome. It's good to have you.
So, pleasure to serve, and hopefully I can contribute in a positive way.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much. Okay, we'll call the roll. Mrs. Dettori?
Here.
Mr. Bates?
Here.
And Mr. Preston?
Here.
Entertain a motion to approve the agenda and addendum items.
Second.
Okay, Mr. Preston? Mrs. Dettori?
Yes.
And Mr. Bates?
Yes.
Thank you. Next item on the agenda is the election of Board of Officers. I will entertain a motion for the election of Office of President.
I'd like to make a motion if you will take that to Mr. Bates, the President.
Second. Okay, thank you. A motion and second. And we'll call the vote. Mrs. Dettori?
Yes.
Mr. Preston?
Yes.
Thank you. Okay. Entertain a motion for the office of Vice President.
I'll make a motion for Deputy Chair.
Thank you. For second. All right, call the vote. Mr. Preston?
Yes.
And Mr. Bates?
Yes.
Thank you. And last, I will entertain a motion or to appoint Cheryl Hatridge, our Administrative Services Manager, as Secretary to the Park Board.
So moved.
Second, please.
Second.
Thank you. Call the vote. Mrs. Dettori?
Yes.
Mr. Preston?
Yes.
And Mr. Bates?
Yes.
All right, very good. Takes care of the election of officers and Secretary to the Park Board. Thank you. Moving on, next item on the agenda is approve or amend the meeting minutes for December 10th, 2019 meeting. A motion bring it to the floor.
Sorry.
Any questions, any discussion regarding the board meeting minutes for December 10th? If not, we'll go ahead and call a vote to approve the meeting minutes. Mr. Bates?
Yes.
Mr. Preston?
Yes.
And Mrs. Dettori?
Yes.
Thank you. Next up is a presentation of the financial statement for the month of December. You see your fund balances there for the general fund, the improvement fund, the capital reserve fund, canine fund, and retirement reserve fund. Any questions on the financial statement for the month of December?
Somewhat
quieter month now. Yeah. There are no questions. The financial statement for the month of December will be entered into the permanent record. Next up is a presentation of vouchers. Bills paid for the month of December. Entertain a motion to bring it to the floor.
Second.
Any questions on the bills paid for the month of December?
Be quiet. There's nothing really.
Your end. Close things out. Questions? We'll go ahead and call the vote. Mr. Preston?
Yes.
Mrs. Dettori?
Yes.
And Mr. Bates?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. All right, moving right along, on to new business. Have a memo from planning department on a stream bank stabilization, repairing and reforestation project that we submitted a grant application for. And so I'd like to entertain a motion to accept the bid award and the contract with River Reach Construction for $191,500 for the Sunnybrook Preserve Stream Bank Stabilization and Repairing Reforestation Restoration Project.
Okay, so moved.
Second. Thank you.
Good question.
Sure.
Just a quick brief, you don't have to spend a lot of time now, but I love looking at this whole kind of bid tabulation thing, but I just, can you briefly tell me what's the difference, total score, weighted score, best value score, like what?
Yeah, so with restoration projects, design build seems to be kind of the sort of preferred delivery method. So since we're dealing with a grant situation here, we have a gross maximum price of $199,000. So pretty much the cost is sort of similar between all the proposing firms. So what they do is when we'll do an RFQ process where we kind of take the firms that are interested, look at their experience, and then we chose three to send proposals out. They give us kind of a detailed proposal. So what we're looking at is approach, how it aligns with our goals for the project and the grant's goals for the project, experience relative to specific projects similar to this type of restoration work, and then they'll propose some preliminary ideas of how they would approach the project. So those are kind of the things we're scoring there, and that's how we're kind of getting that differentiation of between sort of the best value for the Park District as far as we felt River Reach with their experience and kind of their approach to the project, we feel we're getting the most restoration for the value there.
And something else worth mentioning that adds to the weight of how we choose a consultant is, you know, we do have a membership and a great collaboration with Shipley River Watershed Partners. They just have a lot of experience in restoration projects of this type. So they were able to come in the house and help us score the three submittals. So we feel good about it. It should be a good project. Any other questions? Call the vote to approve the bid award. Mrs. Vittori?
Yes.
Mr. Preston?
Yes.
And Mr. Bates?
Good.
Next up is resolution number 1-20, in then and now encumbrance.
It's so good.
Okay, thank you.
I just have to ask, how did this happen? Yes.
Go ahead.
This, I believe, was a data line that was set up for Holbrook. And at the time of it being set up, the representative from Windstream never apparently checked a box that we were either emailed or received a paper copy of this line. We did not know until we received a call from Windstream saying we had asked to.
Can I ask though, is this the only source of internet at that building?
That I don't know. I
only ask that is because I'm not saying you as the finance person, but whoever is in charge of it, you know, how do we not know that we didn't have internet or electricity or gas? Like, those are bills you would look and be like, okay, where's the internet for this building? Where's the, you know, heat for this? I'm just curious how for a whole year somebody was like, wait a minute, why haven't we received a bill yet?
Well, I think it was something that fell through the cracks with some communication between when that was set up and how that information was shared in the process of Holbrook opening and just trying to get everything put together. So
I'm sure it's just a freak thing and that's something we're going to see again.
Well, but no, I would hope that. I think it's, we won't see it.
And we don't have internet at every single shelter. Holbrook and Clarendon, like Orchard Hills, that shelter. So it's not like every single shelter has.
I believe it's
And as we look through the first energy Windstream bills, we as staff have to go through and say, okay, where's this meter? Where's this location? You know, they'll give them names that don't make sense, but yeah. So we did miss it, but yeah. So. Mr. Bates?
Yes.
Mr. Preston?
Yes.
And Mrs. Bishop?
Yes.
Next up is resolution number 2-20, budget amendment number one for the year. We're doing appropriation transfers of $9,600 from the non-department workers' comp account just to be able to have it